What's up, my people? My name is Spicy, and today I have one crazy revenge story coming out of the subreddit Pro Revenge. It is a story with a lot of turns, plot twists, and unexpected events. You need to watch this whole story because you can't properly enjoy it if you don't finish it. Subscribe for more crazy stories, leave a fire emoji in the comments, and like the video. Congratulations, Fishy Cat, for the comment of the day. Ex-boyfriend sexually assaults me, so I destroy him with a few screenshots. I saw a post earlier today about a similar topic, and I wanted to share my revenge too. If someone hurts you, you can take matters into your own hands. When I graduated from college, I moved in with my ex. I will call him Alex. For a while, I had a terrible previous housing situation and my family life was unhealthy. In hindsight, it was the best option I had. We were surprisingly good roommates. Plus, while I looked for my own place and full-time job, I could stay home and help out around the house. I would cook and clean, and then at night we would get some beers or something. That was the symbiotic relationship. Alex hosted and I helped out in every way I could. I will give him this. He was supportive of me in the beginning. But things started slipping through the cracks and he'd say or do stuff that should have been red flags. Alex would comment on my body, saying that I was gaining too much weight and that certain features of mine were too exaggerated. He would hit on older women right in front of me and, because I am bisexual, assume that I would be okay with it. But the worst thing was that when he got angry, he'd see red and fly into a rage, hitting things and yelling at the top of his lungs. The tantrums did not usually last very long, but I would feel physically threatened whenever it happened. I remember one morning when I came home after a party and he, convinced I was cheating on him, tore his hoodie off of me and said, "How dare you wear my clothes when you're out there screwing someone else?" Once he cooled down, I was visibly rattled, but he just refused to talk about it and left the house. He always brushed me off after he got upset, saying he was just stressed. I expedited my house and job hunting, accepting some slightly uncomfortable situations to try to salvage the relationship. We had a lot of heart-to-hearts, but it always ended the same, with him yelling, a finger in my face, and me bawling, feeling totally insane. But I was finally totally independent. This is where things also started getting crazy. Alex was arrested for weed possession and intent to sell soon after I moved out. He called me from jail and needed bail money, but I did not have any. I was totally broke from moving and my job had not paid me yet. I rallied up his friends and they all pitched in. He did make bail, but after that things got worse for me. Once he was released on bail, he drove over to my house, totally wasted, and asked me to hide his bongs and pipes, but I didn't want to be dragged down in the legal case. I told him to leave it in his trunk so he will not drive again. He started to come to my house drunk in the middle of the night and ask why I do not love him and why I was abandoning him and not considering his feelings. He was always angry and constantly called me to see where I was. If I did not get back to him soon enough, he tried to track me down through my friends. It was obviously not a good situation. I realized I had to get out of there, so I broke up with him. He was devastated, and he was pissed. I think that's one of the reasons he did what he did later. It took a few weeks for him to finally stop calling me, and then it was a clean break for a couple of months, but we ended up getting back in contact. After all, Alex had been a really important part of my life, and he was not a bad guy, just a little nuts. I don't know how it happened, but after 6 months of little to no contact with Alex or so, I found an amazing job in a different state, 1,000 miles away. Having largely forgotten about the painful parts of my relationship with Alex, we used my imminent move to start hanging out casually. We got drinks, talked about the future, and I ultimately felt pretty good about being able to be friends with my ex in a healthy way. And then his birthday party came. I was leaving in a few days for the new job, so I figured I'd go out one more time for a last hurrah. He invited a dozen people or so to his house, and one of them was a pretty girl, a mutual friend. I would call her Crystal. It is clear in hindsight that he was grooming us to have a threesome with him that night. He kept feeding us drinks, never letting us go to the bottom of the glass. Before I knew it, it was 4 a.m. and I was drowsy. I didn't know how I got into his bedroom, but there I was, petting the cat. Crystal laid down on the bed and asked me if I wanted to have sex with her and Alex. I shook my head and became keenly aware that my eyesight was swimming and the room felt hazy. She left the room, told Alex I was clearly too tired, and he walked her out. I remember laying down because my chest felt heavy. How much did I have to drink? Alex came back into the room and pinned me onto the bed. I became more and more afraid when I realized that I could not fight him off. He raped me until I started crying too loudly, threatening to wake up his roommate who, frankly, I am shocked he did not come see what was going on. After Alex finally let me up, I got dressed and fled the house, calling a car to come pick me up. But Alex was right behind me. He made me cancel the trip and forced me onto his car, saying that everything was fine. He was just playing rough and, besides, it was his birthday. The closer to my house we got, the more agitated he became. I asked him to pull over, but instead, he sped up to 60 miles per hour in a 35. Once we got to my house, he pinned me against my door, screaming. Eventually, I managed to get inside my house, but I heard him kicking over my trash cans and my gate. I called some friends to get me, afraid for my physical safety. The fact that I actually made it home felt like a miracle. The whole thing was incredibly traumatic. I had no idea he was capable of actually hurting someone, especially me. The next morning after the assault, I woke up at my friend's house with 20 missed calls from Alex. My friends and I decided I should stay at their place until my moving date. I did not want to call the police because I would be forced to recount my story over and over. I knew I would be gaslit again and I had to leave town. Besides, he was already in legal trouble. I have a sense of justice, but I did not want to be the reason he was behind bars. He had texted me a lot along with those calls. Abusive things morph into apologies and back into abuse. So, I decided to do something that I am grateful for to this day. I got him to admit to what happened, with pertinent details. I did this by allowing him to apologize to me via text. He started gushing and did not even bother to refute the facts. I recounted the entire evening, and he agreed that all of it happened. I had what I needed. If I did need to call the cops, if I felt threatened, if he ever reached out to me again, I had it in writing. I backed it up in a Dropbox account. I told him to leave me the hell alone or I called the police. I felt safer. That was supposed to be the end of it. Fast forward to last week, I have moved far, far away, and I'm loving life. Even though I still have nightmares and I started to develop sleep paralysis, I am okay. I got a text from a friend out of the blue saying, "Hey, I have a friend who's dating Alex. Is there anything I should know?" My heart dropped into my stomach. What if he was abusive to his new girlfriend? Would it be my fault if something happened to her? Feeling a sense of responsibility, I told my friend what Alex had done and did not mince words. The new girlfriend should get out of there. Alex called me a couple of days later, and when I did not pick up the phone, he left a huge string of messages. He was livid that I inserted myself into his life. Mainly, he tried to change the story on me, which was pretty shocking on its own. But then, he launched into a weird rant about how he's a good guy and how he had been a great boyfriend to me before I ruined everything by breaking things off. And what happened was not even rape, but it is understandable if my feeling is that I was assaulted. One event does not define whether someone is a good or bad person. Okay, dude, I blocked him and that was that. The last straw though was when my friend, who initially asked me about Alex, asked me to clarify some things about my story because apparently Alex was talking some major bad stuff to his new girlfriend, trying to discredit me and my story. Alex was saying that my mental health was always poor and I made up the whole thing to get back at him for finding a new girlfriend. Plus, I was an abuser and I made stories up all the time. I did not care for that at all. So, I released the Kraken. I got the new girlfriend's number from my friend and extended a friendly hand. I wanted to let her know that I am not insane and that I did not think it was fair for her to have to confront this really strange problem so early on in her new relationship. I then sent her the following. First, an apology, because I know Alex is scary when he's mad and it can be emotionally overwhelming. filming. I asked if she was okay. She said she was, so I continued. I gave her an important clarification on the mental illness thing. I am bipolar, not paranoid. I know the difference between reality and fiction. It is true that it can uproot stability to have a mental illness, but I am not prone to flights of fantasy, and I kept everything in writing just in case this happened. I showed her a text thread I sent to a friend on the night of the assault, timestamped clearly. It recounted all of the details of what happened that night in excruciating detail. This backed up the motelude of proof, the admission of guilt from the rapist himself. Finally, I sent her the text of Alex admitting to everything. The details of those two text threads lined up to a T, proving that I did not change the story and I did not go through that experience for attention. It was real, it was awful, and I was smart about keeping records. Not crazy, not a liar, and about to ruin this guy's life. She thanked me for my time, and a couple of hours later, let me know that she broke things off with Alex, who was going crazy. I felt bad for her, but I was happy to help. Next I heard of him was earlier this week from a mutual friend. Alex is already beginning to lose work with several of the companies he freelances for because word got around about what he did to me and he tried to cover it up. I guess his new ex-girlfriend is the gossipy type. I am honestly not sorry at all. There's so much to say. This was a very sad story for the writer, but overall, his behavior and who this guy was is absolutely disgusting and shameful. He would comment on her body, saying she gained too much weight. He would publicly flirt with women because she is bi, as if that makes it okay. But I believe the worst was the emotional abuse she had to go through. He would turn into a demon when he was mad, raging, hitting and throwing things, yelling and always make the matter around him. She said he was not a bad guy, just a little nuts. But to me, someone who does all these things and ultimately rape her ex-girlfriend is a criminal, a guy with huge problems and issues. Let alone, he's a bad guy. I wish he gets better and change his ways. But for now, he can have the worst and screw himself. I can't wait to see you again tomorrow. I post at 10 a.m. Eastern time every day. I want to thank you for watching my videos. Thank you for liking the video, for commenting, for subscribing, and even for those who share the videos. This really helped me a lot and I appreciate what you do for me. All of our efforts will ultimately allow me to make better videos for you. I still have a bunch of ideas, but without support, I can't get to this point. I wish you all a beautiful day and I hope you are doing your best to reach your dreams, live a fulfilled life, have fun, and love the people around you.